in Venice. Caca Moustique had just received an email from Suki.
Big Penny, come here. I received a very interesting email from Suki.
And what does it say?
Big Penny asks very curiously.
It says we invited to go to a masked ball in Venice, answers Caca Moustique.
Wow, she exclaims. Can we go and pack our bags?
Yes, sure, answers Caca Moustique. While packing, Big Penny couldn't find the ideal dress for the ball because one was too bright and the other one not bright enough. So she decided to call Suki to see if she could help her with this big existential problem.
Hi Suki, I'm in big trouble.
What is it?
I can't find the ideal dress for the ball.
Oh, don't worry. Venice has many fantastic boutiques. And to top it off, this way you don't have to bother packing.
Oh, thank you, Suki, for helping me. Goodbye.
Goodbye and have a nice trip, Big Penny. The long-desired day has finally arrived.
They were leaving for Venice.
The trip was fun. When the plane landed, Caca Moustique went to get the bags. But when he picked up Big Penny's suitcase, he thought it was too light.
Big Penny, Caca Moustique begins, your suitcase is very light. Did you not forget to pack your bags?
Of course not, but as I couldn't find the ideal dress for the ball, I didn't bring anything,
Big Penny answers.
But Big Penny, how do you go to the ball without a dress?
Asks Caca Moustique, worried.
Don't stress yourself. I'm going to buy one here in Venice,
Big Penny answers.
It's okay, murmurs Caca Moustique.
And they went to Suki, who was waiting for them at the airport.
Hi, are you ready to visit all the shops in Venice?
Asks Suki, very excited.
Of course we are,
Big Penny answers.
But Caca Moustique, weren't we supposed to visit Venice?
Asks the snake, worried.
Yes, we were. I'll take care of it, he answers.
Yes, take care of it, and quickly before it's too late, the friends agree.
Okay, says Caca Moustique. We can always leave them in a boutique, and we'll visit Venice.
And so it was, they left Big Penny and Suki in a shop and went to visit Venice. They decided to ride a gondola. The ride was pleasant and relaxing, but Caca Moustique's eyes met those of a female tiger mosquito, very beautiful on the outside, but very ugly on the inside. It was love at first sight. And Caca Moustique couldn't resist going to meet her. So he jumped from his gondola towards her, but the jump wasn't big enough and splash! He fell into the water.
Ah! Help me! Ah! Help! Help me! I will drown!
Shouts Caca Moustique. When Big Penny and Suki heard the screams, they ran out of the store to find out what had happened.
Oh! Caca Moustique is drowning!
They scream in shock.
We have to go and help him, exclaims Big Penny.
But how are we going to do this? Asks Suki.
Each of us extends a paw to grab him,
Big Penny answers. Despite having progressed in swimming, Caca Moustique still couldn't swim well. Finally, they saved him.
Thanks, says Caca Moustique. How can I thank you for saving my life?
Buying us those dresses and shoes in that boutique over there,
Dai sigh. I shouldn't have asked, thinks Caca Moustique. After buying the dresses and shoes, Caca Moustique headed for the ball. But when he got there, his eyes met those of the female tiger mosquito he had seen a few hours earlier. Then he flew across the room to introduce himself and said, "Hi, I'm Caca Moustique, the most famous mosquito on YouTube, and I'd like to meet you.
So, hello, I'm Valentina.
Would you like to dance with me?" asks Caca Moustique.
"Of course I do, since you're famous."
And I danced a lot until Big Penny and Suki arrived. They were fabulous, which caught the eye of everyone in the room. And Valentina whispered to Caca Moustique,
"I wish I had a dress like that and such sparkly shoes."
"Well, actually, they're my best friends," answers Caca Moustique.
"Seriously?"
asks Valentina, invited by a wave of envy when she realized that they were all looking at Big Penny and Suki and not at her. Sighed with rage, she couldn't resist going to sting Big Penny. She flew at great speed towards her. Tiger mosquito bites can be lethal. Realizing what was happening, Suki took off her crystal shoe and threw it towards Valentina. Boom!
"No, Suki!"
shouted Caca Moustique, distressed.
"You're going to break your shoe!"
But Suki had already released it, and unfortunately, Valentina ran away. And the shoe it, Caca Moustique said.
"Ouch!"
Caca Moustique moans.
"I'm sorry,"
Suki says, extremely embarrassed.
"And you really should apologize," complains Caca Moustique.
"But if I had not thrown the shoe, Big Penny could have been bitten, and if we are bitten by a tiger mosquito, we can die,"
justifies Suki. "Seriously?" asks Caca Moustique, scared.
"Yeah, seriously," answer the friends.
"But even so, I'm sad for having lost the love of my life," says Caca Moustique.
"Do not be like that," the snake scolds.
"What if we were to visit other villages in Italy?" proposes Big Penny. "I like Venice so much that I really want to tour Italy."
"Good idea," exclaims the snake.
The end.